Hey, what's up, YouTube? Shoebox Legends here to do a box break today. So, as you see in front of you, we have a blaster of 2019. I was going to say last year's out of instinct, but I guess this is coming up on 2 years old now. Topps Heritage Baseball. So, this is obviously the set that pays homage to the 1970 gray bordered release. I'm not particularly fond of this set. I'm not collecting it. I don't really collect sets anymore. I haven't in years, but quite honestly, I was just so excited to see a blaster available, a baseball blaster in particular, for less than $25 that I probably would have bought it had it been just about anything. I am one of those people. I don't know if I've touched on this in a previous video, but I have not seen any retail blasters or retail product at all in the wild at my local big box stores for about a year now. So I picked this one up at my friend's card shop in Pawtucket, Rhode Island. So felt that, a $5 upcharge from the 1999 suggested retail price was pretty reasonable. So asking price you can see here of $24.95, and it allowed me to support his business. Not that he probably needs it during with what's gone on in the hobby here over the last year or two, but always happy to support him and help him out. So it looks like we have 8 packs included here, 7 packs plus one extra, and we'll see what we pull. This should be fun. Like I said, it's been a long, long time for me, so just happy to have anything to rip as spring is right around the corner here and baseball's about to start up. This should be enjoyable. As with most years, I believe the short print cards in this set are at the very end of the checklist. So, if I'm not mistaken, cards 1 through 400 are the regular short set, and cards 401 through 500 are the short prints. So, and then of course, there's image variations and action variations and inserts and things of that nature. What I like about this blaster, I'll say, compared to the hockey one that I've opened recently, you do get a pretty hefty amount of cards included here. So each pack, as you can see, has actually 9 cards in it, which is not too bad. And times 8 packs, you're getting over 70 cards in this. I think in the Upper Deck Hockey Blaster that I opened recently on the channel, I got more closer to 50 cards. So at least I appreciate that. All right, pack number one. And I may not even recognize all these guys, so we'll see how this goes. Obviously, no Ryan Braun right out of the gate. Robinson Chirinos. Dustin Pedroia, the recently retired Dustin Pedroia. So happy to pull this one. I am quite confident I do not have this in my Red Sox collection yet, so that one will certainly be a keeper. Scott Kingery. I don't think I've mentioned this yet, but it kind of drives me nuts. Pet peeve of mine, players who are not wearing a cap on their card. Travis Shaw, former Red Sox slugger, who I really enjoyed during his time with Boston, has had some success out in the Midwest with the Brewers. Marcus Semien. Here's an all-star subset of Manny Machado, still with the Baltimore Orioles then. Jordan Zimmermann of the Tigers. And closing out the first pack, we have Pedro Strop of the Chicago Cubs. Pack number two. And I should mention, as I see one on the back here, another thing that's cool about this set for me as a Red Sox fan is that obviously Boston won the World Series in 2018. And with this set coming out the following year, the World Series subset cards are pretty Boston heavy. So we saw one on the back of this pack that we'll get to in a second, but definitely increases my odds of pulling some cards for my team collection, which is nice. Brandon Drury of the Blue Jays. Ivan Nova, Chicago White Sox. Shane Bieber. Great first name on this guy, and obviously maybe underrated pitcher. I don't know if you can be underrated with the amount of success that he's had, but that one's a keeper for me. Orlando Arcia. Wilson Contreras. Brad Peacock, Gregory Polanco, Carlos Santana of the Cleveland Indians, and lastly, here is one of those World Series subset cards I mentioned, and probably the one that I'd want to pull the most, which is the team celebrating their World Series championship. Pretty great moment there, commemorated on Cogboard if you're a Red Sox fan. And let's just scan through these first two packs quick to see. Okay, so I do have a short print, which I didn't recognize at the time. So this Wilson Contreras card is one of the short prints from the end of the checklist. Really like his Venezuela armband there. So that's a decent card. I think with the way the short prints fall, I would expect to maybe pull two out of this blaster. All right, next pack, we have another former Red Sox slugger, Josh Reddick, now with the Houston Astros, Jonathan Villar, Julio Teheran, Kyle Calhoun, Elvis Andrus, Hernan Perez. Here's a Rookie Stars card featuring Framber Valdez, Josh James, and Dean Dietz of the much maligned Houston Astros. We have Justin Anderson of the Angels, and Dansby Swanson, the Atlanta Braves. Let's take one more gander. It doesn't seem like the short prints necessarily fall at the beginning or end of a pack or anything, so take a look as I go through those. And let's put this one up for some background. All right, next pack. And we have Giants rookies, Chris Shaw and Aramis Garcia. Angelton Simmons of the Angels. I love this one. Here's an Astros rookie card featuring Kyle Tucker. Very, very big on this guy. I think he's an exciting young player in the sport, and I'm interested to see how he kind of steps up this year now that George Springer is gone and signed with the Blue Jays, expecting Kyle to play a bigger part in the Houston offense. And so I'm not much of a prospector or a player collector, but I have hoarded quite a fair number of Kyle Tucker cards, inserts and rookie cards and things like that, just because I'm kind of curious how his career pans out. So I'm happy to have pulled his rookie in this blaster. That's a winner for me. Kendrys Morales. This one will likely be the card of the blaster as far as I'm concerned. Love the Beatles. Huge fan. Have been ever since I first heard the White Album back in fifth or sixth grade. They were some of the first really good music that I got into independently on my own. And I still listen to them every single week to this day. I will happily hang on to this Beatles Flashbacks card. Really, really happy. I mean, this I honestly probably will end up being my favorite card in the entire blaster, baseball cards aside. We have Alex Colom. Max Scherzer, one of the best pitchers of his generation. A guy that I've actually been looking to pick up some rookie cards of because I think he's still a little bit undervalued based on what he's done. Bryce Harper, another All-Star subset card there. And we have Yairo Munoz, if I pronounced that correctly, of the Cardinals. Just take a look, see if any of these are short prints. Does not look like it. All right, halfway home here. Let's look at pack number five. Thank you for sticking with me. Really appreciate all the comments and camaraderie and support in the early days of the channel. It takes a little while to get rolling and build up some followers, so I really appreciate everybody that's been taking the time to stop by so far. Here's Anthony Rendon of the World Series champion Nationals, Daniel Ponce de Leon, great name, and Dakota Hudson, Cardinal rookies, Wade LeBlanc of the Mariners, Hector Rondon, Houston Astros with almost looks like a freeway behind him, but I think that's just the stadium. Franmil Reyes of the Padres. Not the Padres guy you want to pull out of this set. Corey Dickerson of the Pirates. Carlos Rodon of the Chicago White Sox. Jared Dyson, the Diamondbacks. And Will Smith to end the pack of the Giants. And it looks like the Franmil Reyes card here is actually a short print, so that is likely my second and final short print of the blaster, but we'll see. Next pack, three to go here. We have Yu Darvish in his Cubs gear. Mitch Moreland, another Red Sox card. I'm fairly certain I don't have either, so pretty happy to have that one. Mike Zunino of the Rays. Ryan Yarbrough of the Rays as well. Love the All-Star Rookie Trophy in the Heritage release. So I mentioned in a recent video that I enjoy the All-Star Rookie Cup on the flagship release, but on the Heritage cards, the All-Star Rookie Trophy is even better. It just takes up a larger portion of the card. It's just great. So cool card there. And here's a nice one. So this is a nice shiny foil parallel. And not only that, but I beat the odds in pulling one of my team. So this is a Chris Sale. Looks like he would normally be a short print as well at card number 464. But this is sort of a rainbow parallel or foil board. I don't know what these are called, to be honest with you. This is not the chrome or chrome refractor, something just different, maybe retail exclusive, but awesome. Just a great card to put in my shiny baseball binder of the team I love most. So this is actually turning out to be sort of a winner of a blaster for me here. And right on the heels of that, we have another World Series highlight Red Sox card featuring Steve Pierce, Mike Foltynewicz of the Braves. Have your AL home run leaders, Chris Davis, JD Martinez, and Joey Gallo. This one's interesting to me because I don't know if it's just me, but I feel like given how much everybody loves the home run and the big slugger in this day and age, I kind of feel like all three of the guys depicted on this card are sort of underrated or undervalued. In fact, in my upcoming ComC delivery, which who knows when that's going to get here, I have a Chris Davis rookie card, shiny parallel that I picked up for something like $2 or $3, and you know, given the caliber of his offensive statistics, I just I'm surprised I was able to get it for as cheaply as I was. So, and then here's a cool card from the NLCS. You've probably all seen this one, the When Puigs Fly card. I've seen this on a few blogs, and I love the wordplay, and happy to have a copy of my own finally. I'll take a quick scan. I don't think any of these are short prints. Nope. All right, two packs to go. Thanks for sticking with me. Okay, pack number 7, we have Jesse Biddle of the Braves, Yoan Moncada, the White Sox. I mentioned I don't really like hatless players, but that's actually kind of a funny image with his hair kind of wild like that. And another former Red Sox player who, you know, barely saw any time in Boston before he was dealt away. We have Kyle Freeland, pitcher of the Rockies. Tyler Mahle, I think I pronounced that right, from Cincinnati. Oh, here's a nice Ronald Acuna Jr. New Age Performers. So obviously an insert, but a guy that's pretty hot in the hobby. You know, sort of I think of as one of the big three of the next up-and-coming generation, generally thought of among collectors, and that would be obviously Soto, Acuna, who you see here, and Tatis, whose rookie card is in this release. So nice insert there. We have the Braves rookies next. Colby Allard, Tuki Toussaint, and Kyle Wright. Denard Span with the Mariners. Nice image on this one. Teoscar Hernandez had a really good season with the Blue Jays last year. Very interested to see how his 2021 campaign plays out. And Seth Lugo of the Mets. No short prints there. And we are down to the final pack. Let's see if we can pull a nice Tatis Jr. rookie card here. All right, Ryan Healy of the Mariners, Brandon Morrow of the Cubs. Surprised he's still around. He's been at it quite a while. Steven Souza Jr., the Diamondbacks. Howie Kendrick from the World Series champion Nationals. This, of course, is the year that they won it all. Nomar Mazara, Cardinals rookies, Edmundo Sosa and Adolis Garcia. Carl Edwards Jr. of the Cubs, looks like he weighs about 110 pounds. Marcus Stroman, somewhat underrated pitcher for the Blue Jays, I think. And Jake Junis concludes the blaster. So that's a wrap. Certainly, oh, and you know what? One of those was a short print, the Nomar Mazara. So I actually ended up pulling 3 short prints out of the blaster. Again, just because of the generous number of cards per pack, this actually feels like a decent value to me. I've got a nice sizable brick here of cards if I decide to either put this set together or trade them away. And I got some definite keepers as well for my own collection, aside from the Red Sox World Series card. I did pull 3 short prints, you know, not guys that I'm really that into, but I think these do have probably trade value among people that are putting together the set. The Acuna insert, the shiny Chris Sale, Kyle Tucker rookie, a Shane Bieber and a Dustin Pedroia, and of course, my favorite card of the blaster, the Beatles Go Their Separate Ways news flashbacks. So that's a wrap. Certainly my longest video to date, and if you stuck around to the end, I really appreciate it. I would love to hear from you in the comments below, and we'll be back soon. Thanks, everybody.